Hey, today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV, we're out on the beach with Captain Ryan Folse out of Coco Marina. It's a little bouncy, but we're in the surf. It's summertime. These are where the trout are in all of this white water, and we're going to see what we can catch. I think that's a trout right there. Looks like it's going to be a little bouncy, but it's going to be successful today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.
Boy, coming right
at
him.
Golly, you see their backs coming out the water. This is one of the most incredible sights you'll ever see. These fish are coming out the water. They're right here. There's about 1,000 of them.
That's the way to do it now. That's the way to do it.
Oh, he's got one behind him. There he is. This is absolutely something that you see videos of. And you don't believe it, but look at them. You can look at them in the waves. There's just tons of them.
Oh, a shark! A shark ate him! That's the way to do it now. That's the way to do it. Hey, is this South Louisiana fishing or what?
That is.
You got that one, brother. It's amazing how these trout are, we're in like a foot of water right now. And as rough as it is, it's amazing these trout are in this surf, but they're feeding. And there's some nice fish out here. You come out fishing in the summertime, sometimes you don't know what you're gonna get, but the trout out here this year so far have been some really nice hammer speckled trout. And there's another one right there. I mean, Ryan, that's what, 18 inch trout right
there?
That's
very nice trout, about 18 inches.
Yeah, I mean, that's as good as it gets right there. And you've been catching a lot of them like that.
Yeah, this year, Kevin, early in the year like this, whenever the trout first start showing up on the beach, they're a little bigger.
Right.
And then those bigger ones head out a little bit and then it turns into those young males. But right now, those big females, man, they are chewing. They're about to start laying eggs, and whenever they lay those eggs, they get really mad at these croakers and shrimp. There he is.
There you go. Oh, I just missed one. You know, Ryan, a lot of people think that for speckled trout, you've got to have perfect conditions. The water's got to be calm, it can't be stained, but these fish are out here every day. I mean, they're not leaving in this rougher water that's staying like this. I mean, this is where they eat, this is where they live in the summer. They're not going anywhere just because the weather's not pretty.
You're right. You're absolutely right, Kevin. What'll happen is, you know, even though the water's a little stained up, those fish are still, they're still hungry. It's not super, super dirty today. It's not as clean as I would like it, but, you know, we still have a couple trout biting.
But, I mean, they definitely were sitting out here and taking a little pounding for.
No doubt. Let's see what we have. Yep, right over 18 inches.
I mean, that's good as it gets. You got another one?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Ryan is killing me right now. We're both fishing with croakers, but he seems to have the spot. So I got to see what I can do to get into a better rhythm here. And Ryan, we're basically throwing off of a sandbar. We're in about 2 feet of water?
Yeah, we're setting in probably 3 feet of water, Kevin, and we're right off the ledge. So we're able to cast off into the onto the sandbar, and then it's kind of drifting back off of that ledge, and these fish seem to be right on that ledge. Sure. But that's another very nice trout.
Yeah, I mean, these fish, here, I'll pick him up, show off. Hold on, fish.
He's a still a little green.
Yeah, but I mean, those fish are really, really pretty. Oh, God, look at this. You got one in the rod holder. Look at this.
Look at that trout tooth mark. Yeah.
Look, get your fish. You got him in the rod holder helping me out.
What you got to do, Kevin, you got to ride around until you find a sunk sailboat.
Yeah.
And whenever you find a sunk sailboat, you fish by it.
Yeah.
Well, holds a lot of trout.
You know, we're not the show that gives GPS coordinates because that's just not what we do. But if you find the rig and the sunk sailboat, you pretty much know where we are. Now, that's about a 13, 14 inch trout. So
they still a keeper.
Yeah, but they come in mixed. I mean, their size has been mixed.
Yeah, they have been. They've been a little bigger than this, but hey, look, we'll take this all day long. Beautiful trout. I think I'll have to come over you here, Kev.
That's fine. I've never had my butt whipped like this with croaker fishing before, but hey, it happens. I'm gonna let you get that one out the way. I don't think that one's as... Oh, wait, I got one.
Oh, fighting on a double.
Fighting on a double. What the heck is going on here? That's a nice one.
Fighting on a double. Nice trout. Let's see if Kevin can get his in.
And one of the things that happens with these trout like this is when you get them biting in a certain area, and we're casting in a certain area, you want to get that bait back out there, because you can literally, when you're fishing live bait, one of the great things about it is you can get these fish in a frenzy. And I'm going to have to come on this side of the boat with this one, because he wants to come over here. This is a pretty good fish. It may be a gaff top. He felt like a trout at first. And now he turned into a catfish.
Good old hornhead.
Oh, here we go. All right, Ryan's working on something, so I stole his pole. Hopefully, I've got a trout. I think I do. It's fun when you get this croaker bite and they start biting like this, because you know you can catch a really, really pretty fish on these croakers. The small ones will hit it too. Just because you're fishing with a bigger bait doesn't mean you're gonna catch some smaller fish, but I have got a trout. Finally, I've broken the ice. I had to get Ryan working up in the front of the boat, but I have done it. The ice is officially not broken. Got another one?
Yes, sir.
Looks like you got a trout there, buddy.
I don't quite know what it was. Pulled real hard in the beginning, but if he's a trout, he's not one of those little 14 inchers.
Yeah, he's a trout.
I believe he's gonna be a little bigger.
Yeah, he's right on top of the water, I see him.
Yep, he's busting.
Yeah, he's definitely busting. My little croaker got almost unhooked here, so I'm gonna put him back out. But yeah, that's a nice fish, bud.
Yep, not all bad. Continue this up.
No, it's, I mean, the bite's been fairly good, and it just goes to show you that don't let conditions scare you away. I think people are too scared sometimes about seeing rough water, seeing dirty water. The fish are going to be there. These fish, I mean, what do you think they do? They're going to leave and they're going to go find clean water? Well, the wind's been blowing like this for weeks. So using that philosophy, these fish would either have to go 20 miles offshore or they would have to go to Mississippi or something like that. No, they stay right here. I mean, these fish are right here. That's unbelievable.
See that?
Yeah. I got that one, finally. It's not one as nice as Ryan catches, but hey, you gotta start somewhere, don't you? When these trout hit a croaker, you gotta be patient. As soon as you feel that first tap, look, no way you can try to reel him in. Just let him take the bait. That croaker tastes pretty good. Get him out the motor here. He got mad all of a sudden. There we go.
There you go, Kevin.
The ice is broken. Nice trout. The old catcher's mitt out, keep my hands clean.
Got him that time. Third time's a charm.
Yep. Coquetry, Louisiana is really one of these places. If you want to come fishing, folks, and catch speckled trout in the summertime, there's a lot of great places in the state. I mean, down in Blackman's Parish and everything, but if you want to come really catch some trout on the beach and fish like this, Cocodrie is an awesome place, and you can do it all summer long. This sometimes starts in late April, and then it'll go all the way, sometimes into August, really.
Yes, sir, it sure does. It sure does, Kevin. But early in the year like this, those trout are coming in here spawning a little bit, and they just really mad at those croakers.
And when we talk about what's early in the year, we're in June. We're in the first to mid part of June right now. So really hasn't been real hot out here because we've had weather. I mean, we've had weather like this and wind and rain for 2 weeks now. So we haven't had those days where it's 95 degrees and it's just hard to fish because it's so hot. It's been like this, windy and wet.
You're absolutely right. Not fishing quite ideal conditions with the water clarity, but like you said, those trout are always here and they have to eat sometime.
Yep.
That water's just clean enough to where you can still catch trout.
That's the best bite I had all day. I mean, that one cooked it aggressively. Woo, that was a much, much better bite there. Now, if this isn't a trout, I'm going home. It hit like a trout. It's coming in like a trout. Now let's see if it looks like a trout. Gotta be a trout.
Nice trout.
Thank the Lord, it's a trout. And I got him in. Now that one hit aggressively. And it just goes to show you, just because you fish with live bait, doesn't mean that all the time, these fish are just gonna just annihilate that bait. Today, they've been biting, killing the bait, and then going away. And we have missed probably 80% of our fish this morning fishing live bait. You'd think that would happen with plastic, but hey, it's different every day. We're still catching some nice trout, so we'll see if we can get them to get into a feeding frenzy. I got that one. Whatever it is. Now, I don't know. Oh, that's a trout. This one hit just like a catfish. I mean, this thing hit just like a catfish. Weird bites. Wow. I would have never thought this was a speckled trout, but it is. Funny. I guess with the weather the way it is, the bite's a little bit different, but well, this was a catfish all the way. And look, ain't no catfish about that. Unbelievable. You learn something new about fishing every day. That fish just nibbled that piece of bait like a brim nibbling a piece of corn. That's what it felt like. And if you remember, the fish I caught before that just annihilated it. I said, boy, they're gonna really start biting now. So a strange bite out here today. I mean, really a different bite. And like I said earlier, even when it's live bait, sometimes that bite can be very, very subtle, and boy, that's what it is today. But the fish are worth us getting wet and getting bounced around. So far, so good. I got whatever it is. Started coming in with me.
Big trout.
It is?
I don't know, I hope.
Catfish.
I always hope for the best.
That's trout.
That's a trout.
Nice trout. Ooh, yeah. Good speckled trout here, boys. Come on, buddy. There we go. We move to the front of the island. And again, getting the strange bites, not really knowing what we have. And I just missed the fish a minute ago. As soon as it hit the water, croaker comes flying out the water, the trout hit it. Cast right back in the same spot, and there he is. So maybe we're on a bunch of fish right here. You're about to find out. How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Dimco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
All right, guys. What I like to do is I start off with about a 15-inch leader with a barrel swivel, a weight on top of it, kale hook, and I like using croakers. We just hook that croaker directly through the mouth like that, and that's how I do it. Carolina rigging for speckled trout.
I got one, there we go. All right, come on here. I think we got a trout, Ryan.
That's what it's looking like.
I think it is. I'm pretty positive.
Oh, yes,
it is.
Yes, sir.
Come on up. Surprise. Nice trout. Made another little move behind a little island. We're gonna see if we can finish everything up right here. Looks like we got a lot of birds. Look at the bait. You got birds and bait, everything back here. The birds are diving a little bit. Spot looks great, water looks good. We'll see if we can finish things up right here. Oh yeah, baby.
We on them now, Kevin.
You gotta love it when they start biting every cast. This is a good fish, y'all. Real good fish. I saw him come up. Ron, how much water are we in here now at this spot?
Well, I dropped my anchor in about 5 feet of water, but we're casting back to like a foot and a half.
Okay.
It's a little shelf right out here. And the birds were diving on it. The water was pretty, Kevin, and it kind of gave us a good sign that the fish were here, and they sure are.
Well, this is going to be a, oh my goodness.
You want the net?
Should have the net, but let's see.
Whoa, nice trout. That's what we're looking for.
Nah, that's a pretty fish there. Whew. I should have got the net.
Yes. That's the time we just lost for me trying to swing it in.
Yeah.
Nice trout.
For those of you that say, Cocodrie's not known for big trout, well, you know what? They're not known for 7 and 8 pound trout, but if you want to catch 2 and 3 pound trout, and this one is getting a little bit over 3 pounds right here, you can find them. Beautiful Cocodrie yellowmouth speckled trout. Check that one out. That's awesome. When you're fishing with croakers, a lot of time you're gonna lose a fish. And with a shrimp, usually they take the shrimp away from you. But with croakers, you can kind of get an idea of what you had. And if you look right here, I had a bite, and that is a tooth mark in that croaker. So when you reel in your line, and if you're wondering if it's speckled trout that hit it, look at that croaker and see if you see any teeth marks. If you got teeth marks, then you've got a pretty good chance that it was a speckled trout. This is a perfect example right here because it just caught one, but you can see the teeth marks right there where he hit it. That's teeth doing all that. So look at your bait, and another hole right there. So look at your croakers and check them out, and you can tell what's hitting your line. If it's catfish, that's not gonna happen. So just a little tip for you when you're fishing live croaker. You got another bite?
I do.
You got him, huh?
Yep.
Ryan, what makes these fish hold here in the summertime like this? I mean, what is it about these islands and these sand flats and everything?
Well, the last couple weeks, Kevin, what's happening is we're having a lot of shrimp coming out the marsh into these bays.
Uh-huh.
And once they hit these islands, they, you know, the trout are just underneath the shrimp. I mean, and it's just rafts and rafts of shrimp, and the trout are underneath them. And whenever you see those birds working, it's usually a pretty good sign that there's a lot of shrimp.
Uh-huh.
And underneath the shrimp is a lot of trout.
And what is it about these croakers that, I mean, you guys fish with a lot of croakers, and you can't get them, you fish with minnows, but what do you like, what is it about the croakers that you like fishing with them so much?
Well, naturally, croakers, they actually eat the trout eggs. So trout just hate croakers. A lot of times, even if the trout are not real hungry, they'll still try to kill that croaker. So you're getting bites, you know the trout are there, and sometimes you might fish a little bit longer at a spot where you're not catching fish, but whenever you, you know, said about those teeth marks in the croakers, whenever you reel them in like that and you can see the teeth marks,
yeah,
you know it's trout, so you just try to grind it until you start biting them.
Hey, look, you're not gonna catch a trophy speckled trout every time you're fishing a croaker, but you have a chance, a better chance to catch a big trout on a croaker than you do on a live shrimp. Actually, a croaker or a finger mullet. Those are your two best shots. I mean, he's just there. He's just playing with that bait. I got another one. Oh, God.
Oh, I got one, too.
You got yours?
I lost mine, too. Oh, he come back for it. Look at that.
You got it?
They must be pretty thick out there.
Well, they are pretty thick, and we've had a great day out here fishing with Captain Ryan Folse, folks from Coco Marina. Look, if you want to come out and have a great time, Coco Marina's got a great restaurant, overnight accommodations, and they got these bigger boats. So if you have a group of 6 people, 5 people, and you want to get them out to catch specks and reds on bigger boats, you can come out here and fish with our friends from Coco Marina. Hey, we caught some nice trout today. It lasts like this all summer long, and then we get into redfish season in the fall. So come on out, give us a call. Hey, don't forget to check us out on Facebook, like us at Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV, and follow us on YouTube as well. You can like our channel at Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. For producer Joey Bordelon, I'm Kevin Ford, and we hope to see you next time right here for another edition of Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. Thank you, my buddy.
Oh, thank you, Kevin. Enjoyed it. It's good times.